It's AumSum time!
Why do we get headaches? Because of your questions, dude! Very funny. Many of us have experienced pain in our upper neck or head at some point. This pain is called a headache. Headache is not an indication of our brain hurting. In fact, the brain does not have any pain receptors to experience pain. Pain originates in nerves surrounding the brain, sending pain signals to the brain, resulting in headaches. Headaches are commonly categorized as primary and secondary. Primary headaches are caused due to inflammation or overactivity of muscles, nerves, and blood vessels in the head or neck. Migraines and tension headaches are common examples of primary headaches. Now, when an illness or a medical condition in the body triggers the pain-sensitive nerves in our head, it causes a secondary headache. Dehydration, hangover, sinus, or even heart disease are some examples of conditions that could trigger secondary headaches.
What is depression?
It is a 5-star hotel deep underwater.
As usual, you are wrong. In our life, all of us feel sad or depressed for some time. But that doesn't mean we have depression. Many doctors use a manual named Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders to diagnose depression. It has a list of symptoms which include sadness, worthlessness, hopelessness, changes in appetite, suicidal thoughts, sleep problems, etc. If we have 5 or more of these symptoms for at least 2 weeks, then doctors diagnose us with depression. The exact causes of depression are unknown. But studies suggest that people who have depression may have a smaller hippocampus, an area of the brain that regulates emotions. Moreover, genetics might also play a role. Studies have shown that a variation in the serotonin transporter gene makes us more prone to depression. Environmental factors such as coping with the death of our beloved ones, traumatic events, etc., can also cause depression. Why do we get eye bags?
It is a sign indicating that we need to take a long holiday.
No. One of the main reasons for eye bags is aging. As we age, various changes take place in our body.
Yeah, dude. I get more attractive with age.
Yeah. Now listen. Our skin contains collagen and elastin. They keep our skin firm and elastic. In addition to this, we have fat tissue surrounding our eyes for cushioning. But as we age, our skin produces less collagen and elastin, causing our skin to become loose. Also, the muscles and ligaments that hold the fat tissue in place begin to get loose and the fat starts drooping down. This loose skin and fat make the area around our eyes appear swollen, giving us eye bags. Besides this, heredity, salt intake, smoking, etc. may also contribute to the formation of eye bags. Topic: pathogens. Why do we get fever?
So that we can take a holiday from work.
Fever is a protective response of our body to fight against pathogens such as bacteria, viruses, and fungi. These pathogens cause diseases. Hence, when pathogens enter our body, the immune cells such as white blood cells produce chemicals called pyrogens, which are released into the bloodstream.
I thought like movies, they are released in theaters.
Please, pay attention. Hypothalamus, which is a small part of our brain, regulates our body temperature. However, when these pyrogens reach the hypothalamus, it starts to raise our body temperature, thus producing fever. Now, one of the reasons for producing this fever is that many pathogens cannot survive at high temperatures. Thus, they die and we remain safe.